Hi, my name is Mark Brown. I work in the Windows Azure team at Microsoft, and today I'm going to show you how easy it is to get started using Windows Azure Websites with Visual Studio 2013. Windows Azure Websites is a PaaS for web developers. All you need to do is deploy your code, and Azure takes care of the rest. Azure Websites is great if you want to quickly build and deploy a new site, do dev and test, or migrate an existing site already in production. Azure Websites has support for great features like custom domains, SSL, autoscaling, and provides an SLA on just a single standard instance rather than two or more instances for web roles or VMs. Okay, let's get started. So the first thing I want to show today is how you can create a website and publish it to Windows Azure Websites completely within Visual Studio. So I've got Visual Studio 2013 open, and I have the Windows Azure SDK 2.2 installed. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to connect Visual Studio to Windows Azure, or to my subscriptions on Windows Azure. I'm going to click on Server Explorer, and then right-click on Windows Azure here, and then I can click Manage Subscriptions. New within the Windows Azure 2.2 SDK, I have two ways I can connect Visual Studio to Windows Azure. I can use my corporate credentials and sign in just as I do into the Windows Azure portal, or I can use certificates like you can do today. I'm going to select Import here, and then I'm going to import my subscriptions from this settings file. Here you can see I have two subscriptions inside here. I have my MSDN and another one right here. I'll go ahead and close this. So with my subscriptions imported, I can go ahead and open this up, and you can see a full list of resources and services available within here, and I can go ahead and just start opening these up. So I'll go ahead and click up on storage, virtual machines, and websites within here. And you can see lots of different storage accounts, some virtual machines, and websites available within there. A new feature available within this tab now is I can go ahead and right-click on the Windows Azure and click Filter Services. And within here, I can optionally select which subscriptions I want to include or exclude within here. I'll go ahead and select this one. I can also select which regions I want to show up. So if I only want to see specific regions within here, I can select that as well. And then we'll just say apply. After I do that, you can see the list of things within here are starting to refresh. Okay. So now I've got my subscriptions imported and I've got them filtered so I know that I'm using the right subscription within Visual Studio. Let's go ahead and create a new website and publish it completely within Visual Studio. The first thing I'm going to do is right-click Websites, and I'll say Add New Site. Within here, I see a dialog again where I can go ahead and sign and use my corporate credentials or the Manage Subscriptions tab. I've already done that, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to create a new website and give it a new name. We'll call this Mark's Website 1, and it checks out so that URL is available. And I'll make the location here in the Eastern US, and I don't need a database. So let's go ahead and just click Create. And we'll give that just a moment here to go ahead and provision a new empty website for us. Great, that's ready to go. All right, let's create a new project. I'll go File, New Project, and I'll select a new ASP.NET web application. And let's call this Mark's Website 1. Click OK. And we'll select an MVC project or template. And let's let Visual Studio create that out. Now, let's go to Solution Explorer. We'll go ahead and I want to go ahead and just modify the homepage a bit. So we'll open up Index and we'll say Mark's new website. Whoops, Mark's new website. And then just put a little text in here. Mark's new website created with Visual Studio 2013 and deployed to Azure Websites. Great. Go ahead and save that. Let's just give that a quick run, make sure everything's okay. And there we go. Okay, everything's good to go. So I've got my new project created, I'm ready to go. All I need to do now is I can right click and select Publish. Now before, we had the ability to be able to import published settings files. Now, we can make that even easier because I can see the websites that I've now provisioned within Visual Studio and then just go and select that. So I'll select my new website here and it'll download the pub settings file and then import it straight into my project. Everything looks good. We'll select the defaults there, keep going, and publish. And now we're going ahead and Visual Studio is going to publish my site. And there we go. So there's my new website, completely within Visual Studio, where I provisioned a new empty website right within the IDE, created my new website, got the site pub settings file, and then published it. And here it is. And that took maybe just, I don't know, 2 or 3 minutes. Next thing I want to show is how to go and create a new website and then publish it from a source code repository. Windows Azure Websites has a really great feature, so you can publish it either from web deploy, or you can publish it from a source code repository like GitHub or even Visual Studio Online. So let's go ahead and create Mark's website 2, and we'll keep everything the same. And we'll go ahead and create that site. Great, so now I have a new empty website in there. Let's go in and I'm going to close this solution. And I'm going to create a new project. Website 2. And I'm going to add it to source control. Select the MVC template. There we go. So it's going to allow me to choose the source control. I'm going to go ahead and select Git. Okay, let's go ahead and modify the home page a little bit. We'll call this Mark's Website 2. And welcome to Mark's website created in Visual Studio 2013 and deployed using TFS Git to Windows Azure. All right, go ahead and save that. Great. So now I need to go and create a Git repository for that website. So let's go ahead and click on Server Explorer. We're going to right click on our website. And you can see here, I have lots of settings that I can select within here. I can turn on log streaming within here. I can also view settings for the site, so I can select the framework version, turn on logging, failed request tracing, all sorts of things. I want to open this up in the management portal, so I'll go ahead and select that. So this will send me to the dashboard directly for my website. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to set up deployment from source control. So I'll go ahead and select that there. And as you can see, we have lots of different options for source control or deploying from source control within here. Whether it's a local Git repository, GitHub, Dropbox, Bitbucket, CodePlex, or an external repository that supports both Git and Mercurial repositories. I'm going to select local Git. We'll go ahead and select next there, and then this will go ahead and create a Git repository for this website. And here I've got the Git URL to my repository. So let's click that. I'll click the copy button. And now I've copied that to the clipboard. Go back to my project, got my source code, my modified home page. Now we'll click on Team Explorer, click on the changes, and then we want to commit our changes within here. So we've got all these files to add, and then of course there's the changed index file here. And we'll just type in a commit message. So initial commit and change the home page. And then I'm going to select commit and push. And then give that a second, it's going to ask me for the Git URL to the remote repository. That's the URL I just copied out of the portal. So let's go ahead and paste that in here and click publish. And now I should be able to go back and let's refresh the page here. Click on my deployments and I can see I now have a new website deploying into Windows Azure. We'll give that just a moment. And there we have a new active deployment, and you can see my commit message right in here, so I know it's the right one. So we'll go ahead and open that up, and there it is. The nice thing about this is that anytime I make changes now, I can stay right within Visual Studio the whole time. So let's go back and we'll say, I love it. And we'll click save. Go back to changes, commit that, change homepage again, loving it. And we'll do a commit and push. And let's go back to here. And there we are deploying a new change. That's our now active deployment. We'll go ahead and click browse again. And there you have it. Okay, that's it. Well, thank you very much for joining us. For more information on Windows Azure, go to windowsazure.com. Thank you.